Welcome to Graphic Hunt YouTube channel. In this photo effects tutorial, we'll learn how to turn any image into a bunch of Polaroids. It may look complicated at first, but as we'll see, it's actually a very easy effect to create in Photoshop. This is the photo I'll be using for this tutorial. And this is the final extract after all steps. Let's get started. After opening the image in Photoshop, select the rectangle tool from the tools bar or just by hitting U in keyboard. In the options bar, leave the tool mode to shape, fill color to black and the stroke to none as set by default in Photoshop. Now, drag out a square shape over the image using the rectangle. Hold the shift key to create a perfect square. We can see a new shape layer rectangle 1 in the layers panel. Duplicate it by clicking and dragging to the Add New Layer icon at the bottom of the Layers panel. Photoshop automatically names it Rectangle 1 Copy. For your reference, double-click on the name and rename it to a different one. Here, I name it to Image Part. Similarly, rename the Rectangle 1 layer as Border. Move the cursor to the Options bar and change the fill color to white. Now select the Move tool from the Tools bar. Check the Show Transform controls in the Options bar, which always shows the transformation box over the selected layer. Click and hold Alt or Option and the Shift keys and drag one of the box handles until you find an enough size to the border. Release all the buttons and hit the Commit Transformation button or hit Enter in keyboard. To make it a Polaroid, drag the bottom side handle downward a little bit. Now let's add a little shadow to the border. Click the Add Layer Style icon in the Layers panel and select Drop Shadow. In the Layer Style dialog box, set the Blend Mode to Multiply, Opacity to 40%, Angle to 135 degree, check on Use Global Light if not on, Distance to 15 pixels, Spread 0% and size 15 pixels. Click OK to close it when done. Here is the shadow effect so far. Now we have to reveal the image area behind black part of the Polaroid. To do so, make the image part layer active and choose blending options from the Add Layer Style flyout menu. In the advanced blending mode, lower the opacity to 0% and change knockout to deep. Click OK to close it. Hold down Shift key and select both the shape layers and drag them to the folder icon, that is to create a new group. Double click and rename it. Click on the background layer and select solid color from the Create New Fill icon at the bottom of the layers panel. Make sure the color is black and hit OK. This brings a color fill layer in the layers palette. Now select the Polaroid group and then the Move tool from the tools bar. In the options bar, check the auto select on, and change from layer to group mode. Then make the show transform controls also on. Enabling the auto select option will allow us to select layers or a group of layers within the canvas itself instead of going onto the layers panel. Simply drag and adjust the position and the size of the Polaroid according to the appearance of the photograph as needed. Now at this point, the hard work is finished and the rest is duplicating the Polaroid group. Hold the Alt or Option key and drag the Polaroid to clone a copy of it. In here, I just move the copy to the other face and rotate a little to make some difference from the first one. Continue this step for as many as you needed according to the appearance of your image. For this picture, first I focus on the subjects. That is the children faces. There are 5 faces in this picture, so I plan to make them as the foreground of the main subject. Hence I create another copy of the Polaroid and drag it below the layer Polaroid and rename it as Polaroid Background. I now, Group all other Polaroids except the Polaroid background by selecting them with the help of Shift key and lock them to avoid any accidental changes. Now I have to play with the Polaroid background to make more copies with different sizes and move them around the main subjects. This part is done and can be grouped if necessary as I did before. Now double click on the solid color fill layer, not on the mask. This brings the color picker dialog box. Do not pick any color, instead pick one from the inside of the Polaroids. I pick a light green from the grass to coincide with the farmost background. Here's the full picture so far. I also lower the opacity of the color fill layer within the layers panel to 50% to maintain its reality. I hope you follow the instructions step by step. Wish you all success. Please like and subscribe.